Welcome to 41 Nosh, One Tang Travel. I am on the road once again with Rise Up host Eric Oblander. We are about an hour east of Toledo in Marblehead, doing a whole day of fun activities, and we're starting things off with Bruno's Pizzeria. Eric, we picked this place because you recommended it. Tell me a little bit about Bruno's.
I can't believe I'm getting paid to come to a place that I come to all the time to eat. Every time we come to Marblehead, we always come here. The family comes here. We go to the lighthouse. We go to the beach. We always come to this place to eat pizza. We've been doing it for years. It's one of my favorite spots. It's a happy place for us. We think about it all the time. We finally got here.
And I'm his guest today. This is almost like Eric's show today because I am going to get the tour.
It's always my show anyway when I'm around because I'm not going to shut up. But this place is so great. I'm glad I got to recommend it to you. And hi, my name's Eric. Welcome to 41 Nosh.
Let's go eat some pizza. We're going to try it right now. We're going to meet the GM here, and we're going to try some of the delicious pizzas, wings, and a little bit of everything they have. Let's go. Opened in 2008, Bruno's boasts award-winning pizza, locally sourced ingredients, and an atmosphere welcoming to all.
Our goal was somewhere to make it comfortable for people to come in and eat with their families. So we didn't want a bar or anything like that. We want to have that available because there might be people coming out, families coming out that want to get a beer, might get draft beer, or want to get a mixed drink or stuff like that. But our overall goal was we wanted this to be a family environment for everyone to come in. And the building owner, Bob Keller, he did an amazing job when he designed this place and just made it, like, as you see it today, it's beautiful with what the designs and everything he did in it.
Do you notice a lot of recurring customers? Because this is kind of a vacation area too, so you have a mix of locals and people sort of getting away too.
Absolutely. During winter time, it kind of dies off a little bit out here, but we still have a lot of locals that come out and support us and everything like that, that we're very appreciative for. I get people constantly coming from 2-3 hours away coming out here just because this is their favorite pizza place and they want to come back, and because there's nowhere like it. And we try to make sure that they're going to be coming out here, that they're going to be getting their best experience that they can get.
This guy right here, this is why I was led here. He is a recurring customer.
Yeah, my family comes to Marblehead about every couple weeks, and we always come here. We stumbled into it one time, and then every time we come here, straight up just cheese pizzas. Man, I love this place.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah, it's something that we've just been trying to do over the years, is every year we go through our menu and we just try to reevaluate what works, what doesn't work, what did we sell, what sold really well, what didn't sell really well, and then we just build our menu off of that year by year by year.
One pizza that's always a top seller and a staple on the menu is the award-winning Old World Pepperoni.
So I'll start off by just putting a layer down of regular traditional pepperoni down.
How does one win an award for Old World Pepperoni?
So every year, the Rotary Club of Ottawa County will host this event where they invite all of the local pizza places to bring basically pizza in, and all the locals will come out, they'll all get to try whatever pizzas they want to try, and then they'll get to vote on what their favorite is.
So it's pretty simple. You put a layer, what'd you put down, mozzarella cheese first?
Mozzarella sauce and cheese first, regular pepperoni, traditional pepperoni, and then I just top it with a little bit of extra cheese on top. And then after it comes out of the oven, we'll put a little bit of Italian seasoning on it and cut it, and it'll be good.
Why do you do the square pieces?
Easier for customers to eat. When it gets to a 14-inch pizza, the pizzas start to get a little bit bigger, where they start to slag, you lose your toppings and everything like that.
And the Old World is just the ones that are kind of curled up?
Yeah, the Old Worlds are the one that's curled up, like right over here. Our dough is made locally around here at Feddersen's Dough Company in Huron.
One thing I like is you were mentioning, like, you do wings, you do your own sauce, you do white sauce pizza, you do your own ranch. Yep. You got these Parmesan pops that are like little dough balls. So everything is like made in house, which I think is very unique. As much as we possibly can,
because it's a better product. We know where it's coming from, how it's being made. It's not coming from a factory where it could have been bad quality or anything like that. We know what we're preparing ahead of time, and so we already know what it should taste like, what it's supposed to come out like, what it's supposed to look like, and because of that, then we don't have any differentials between orders or anything like that. So that's kind of another goal that we have here, is to give everyone the same product. over and over again, because that's what you come back for, is what you got the first time.
Yeah, the consistency is always, we always get the same thing, it always tastes exactly the same, it's always delicious, they never mess it up.
Eric, this is a spread.
Dude, we have very cool sunglasses on, we have tons of pizza and wings, and he just dropped off this cookie. What is going on? This is phenomenal.
What's the name of that cookie?
This is an exotic name. You ready?
Okay.
Chocolate chip cookie.
That's very creative. I don't know if I've ever had it. It looks great. It's a new menu item, too. So we'll finish with that. We have Jordan and Allie behind on the camera, so they're going to help us. You guys can't see them. They're going to help us when we're all done. There they are. That's that award-winning Old World pepperoni. He showed me in the award. You know what I like about those is you get that like crunchy edge on it. It's almost like eating a crunchy piece of bacon.
It is like got that crunch, and the dough is, their dough here is so good. Mm-hmm. It's always like perfectly got that spongy, good bounciness. Mm.
And then we got these little balls, maybe before we get into the wings. Cheers to you, my friend.
Cheers, buddy. Ding. Socially distanced cheer.
If we weren't going through COVID, I would definitely try the toss. So this is Bruno's Pizzeria in Marblehead. Obviously so much more than pizza. We got wings.
I bet I've been here 25 times. I've never had anything but pizza here. So this is like a total adventure.
This is brand new for you. And brand new for me too. Check it out, Marblehead. Make the trip over here. We're in Port Clinton right now at Twin Oast Brewing. We are inside, outside with GM and owner Corey Smith. Thanks for welcoming us out.
Yeah, not a problem. Thanks for coming out, guys.
This is an awesome place, and that kind of sounds generic, but there's no other word to describe it. I mean, this amazing plot of land and this beautiful brewery you put here. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, so this is a 60-acre farm. Our family kind of took this farm over in 2008. And ever since then, we've been trying to resurrect it as a farm, because before it was this big, beautiful orchard, and then nature took over. And so that coincided perfectly with my dad, who wanted to retire to be a farmer. But my dream ever since, you know, senior year of college was to open up a brewery. And so I've been homebrewing for about 10 years, and turning that passion into an actual business is something that the family all jumped on board with. And we figured out why not just kind of use the farm and the brewery hand in hand. So we call ourselves a farm to fermenter brewery, meaning the farm sustains the brewery and the brewery sustains the farm.
Do you grow your hops here?
Not all of them. We have a little bit of hops. We tried to grow some hops in the past, and it just hasn't been the best thing for us yet. We are trying to plant a few acres in the future here that we can use, but right now we've just been tinkering with it. Mostly what we grow here are stone fruits, peaches, apricots, fun things like pluots and apriums, cherries, all those kind of things. So we're more of a stone fruit and vegetable farm than anything else.
Most of the breweries I've been to, for the most part, are indoors. This kind of, in a way, has like a vineyard, like wine feel, but then you come here and drink beer. Was that like intentional when you had the farm?
Absolutely. So inspired by things like Napa Valley, and then also, I don't know if you know of New Glarus out in Wisconsin. They're a fruit sour brewery, and big inspiration on my end. I love their beer, but also kind of their whole vibe is a lot of outdoor space. You can go wander around, have little nooks and crannies for people to sit and gather, and we figured why not do the same thing.
So I started with the Old Ohio, which you said is kind of that's the go-to here, right?
Yeah, so that's the go-to, especially in the tap room. It's our best seller day in and day out. A very simple, easy, light-bodied beer. Very small hint of citrus from the hops that we use, but it's extremely approachable and drinkable. Some of the beers that we brought on were things that I was homebrewing. So this Legitimate Swells is one that we just tweaked once we went big scale, but that was almost 100% mine.
That one is really good.
I like it, yeah.
Very mellow.
And the idea behind that is it's kind of like a clear version of a New England IPA.
You purposely chose the Ice Shove. Why did we have this one out of the whole selection?
So the Ice Shove is it's a Belgian IPA with apple and rosemary. The idea was I wanted to show off the farm to fermenter theme. So when we have apples, you know, we pressed them, got some juice, grew the rosemary ourselves, and that was what was used in this one. So right now, out of all the beers we have, this is the only one that has our farm ingredients still in the beer.
We've had you talking here for about 10 minutes. Why don't you take a quick sip? You're getting a little parched. And my favorite name, maybe Rutherford B. Hayes of any beer name ever. Cheers. Yes. Clink, clink. It's about 90 degrees out here, so if you see these beers flying fast, you know why. Boom, it's a chocolate stout.
Yes, Boom Chocolaca is the full name. It's a milk stout, a sweet stout, so it has lactose to give it some body. And we put milk chocolate and dark chocolate right in here.
This would be good by a campfire, like if you don't have s'mores, drink this. And you guys have food too, so I mean, obviously people are drinking here, they want to eat something too. Tell us a little bit about your food menu.
Yeah, so we try to be a gastropub. So we always say it's upscale bar food. We have really good burgers that are, you know, double smash burgers. We do perch tacos, which is a house specialty. So normally people do tacos with like a salsa and sour cream. This is a little bit different. And then we just added a wood fire pizza oven. You'll see the stone around there. It's the same stone we use in the Oast. It's the same stone you see down on the water feature, and that's all local, just dug up from the ground right here. So it was kind of cool. We try and be hyper local with everything.
So this is an Oast.
Well, this is the idea of an Oast. An Oast really is where they would dry hops in England. So we kind of fell in love with the Oast structure and realized that it was a good, you know, collaboration between farming and brewing to have this Oast. And so normally this would be enclosed, it'd be attached to the building. We kind of took our own liberties with it, made it a fun place, a bar. We had a fire pit over here, so cozy little gathering spots for people.
And you have owls in here too.
Yes, the owls, the hooties, those are kind of like scarecrows for the birds. So after last year, we realized people were getting surprised by birds on the shoulders. And so we threw a couple owls up there and take care of that.
I don't know if we mentioned this, but it's on its way. The giant pretzel, which just seems to fit. We have a variety of sauces here to dunk this in. Cheers to you, Corey. Thanks a lot, man.
Thank you.
Appreciate you.
Cheers.
For having us out. Check it out. It's in Port Clinton. It's Twin Oast Brewing. Maybe pull Corey aside and he can go through this whole spiel again for you. I don't know. You enjoy doing that?
Every day. It's my favorite thing.
We're wrapping up this One Tank Travel at the Marblehead Lighthouse. Eric, you know a little bit more about this than I. What is it?
I have taken the tour of that lighthouse. It's actually much higher up when you get up there than it looks like it is from here.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's pretty great. It's the oldest lighthouse working. It's a working lighthouse. Oldest one on the Great Lakes. And I know that for two reasons. One, I've taken the tour. And two, I just read that plaque over there.
Yeah, it's Ohio's historical marker plaque. You can get a lot of information.
It's cool. You can see Cedar Point just around that corner, too.
We could go down there and look at it, but we're running out of time. So come out here in Marblehead, check out the lighthouse, come along Lake Erie. It's a great way to sort of have a staycation an hour east of Toledo. Great spot. Check it out. Eric, this was fun.
It was a great time. Perfect weather, perfect friends. It was awesome.
I'll see you back at work.
All right. Yeah.
All right. Take it easy.
See you later, man. Bye-bye.